So with the other videos, the other webinars rather, I've posted this workflow, this data flow, to kind of frame the topic as to how everything works together in terms of information. You know, we have the Inventor application. I always consider Inventor more of an engine in terms of how it processes different information. So when working with some sort of configurator, if you want to leverage Inventor, you want to leverage automation, you want to leverage iLogic, this is a very common flow of information. Now, typically we'll have the Inventor application, and it's going to consume and use different files. Those files are IPT, IAM, DWG, IDW. And then there's some interaction with Vault. But if you really want to automate something, if you really want to drive some level of automation to assist with your engineering processes, you're going to have to incorporate some of this on the left-hand side as well. You know, what is the logic that is associated with developing, you know, different product configurators? You know, how do things go together? What are their relationships? What's their fit, form, and function? You know, that's all business logic. Typically, within engineer departments, we have individuals that have that information. Sometimes, if we're efficient and we're you know, we want to make sure that everything is easily accessible, then we'll have some level of documentation as to what that business logic might be. In the form of internal standards, you know, industry standards, things along those lines, so we can use that as part of our business logic as well. Excuse me. In order to work with that business logic, typically we'll have some level of interface. It could be a UI, it could be an iLogic form, it could be some means to input information and interact with the logic. And then sometimes we're going to need to consume other information that maybe have been produced by other departments within our company. Typically, you know, this is sales. Sales will go and they'll configure something, or they'll have some idea as to what a customer is looking for in terms of criteria. Sometimes that information will be stored in some external data source, Excel files, maybe a SQL database, some other type of database. If that's the case, we can access that information, consume it, and then use it with Inventor in order to configure our models and our drawings to ultimately arrive at a particular design or configuration with minimal or even sometimes no human interaction whatsoever. So that's what the Inventor configurator data flow is all about, is how does that information interact with one another? And this is a great visual to understand what those steps might be and those types of things that you need to take into consideration. So in today's webinar, we're going to be focusing simply on iLogic. So this bit right here, the business logic and the means to arrive at that business logic. So in December 2008, I pulled this up. I found this in, I think it was like some sort of CAD magazine online website that kind of explains what iLogic is all about. Those of you that aren't familiar with iLogic, it comes with Inventor. It's been involved and incorporated in Inventor for many years now, excuse me. But what iLogic does is it enables designers to capture and embed engineering and product knowledge directly into Inventor models, paving the way for rules-driven design. And that's what iLogic is all about. It's developing rules and conditions for how our models interact with one another. iLogic creates smart parts and smart assemblies, if you want to take it to that level, that define product behaviors and can embed higher levels of design intelligence directly into the Inventor model. That's through a user interface designed for users with little or no programming experience. And that last bit, you know, some people might be a little intimidated by that, but in all actuality, it's very true. I mean, you can, if you've never even done anything in terms of writing code or logic, the iLogic rule editor really does give us an ability to start creating some level of automation without having any programming experience. And I'm going to demonstrate a little bit of that here in just a moment. iLogic was created to fill a need for mid-range manufacturing CAD software. particularly Inventor. It allows designers to integrate intelligence into 3D models. Rules-based design, when developed properly, increases consistency and quality. Man, I cannot express that enough, because that's exactly what iLogic is designed for. It was developed to do just that. How do we do things over and over again exactly the same way, as opposed to recreating the wheel every single time? As we all know, every individual that does something in a CAD application, given to their own devices, might do it somewhat differently. And that kind of gets away from consistency, and sometimes it can even impact quality. iLogic allows us to maintain that consistency and quality while improving throughput and performance. The less you have to interact with something or have to touch something from a human experience perspective, the faster, typically, it will operate. Decisions, conditions, and criteria can be written in code and applied to designs. It takes away that tribal knowledge embedded in individuals that work in engineering, and it gives it a single source of truth, a means to catalog or index that intelligence and that logic, so that way it can be used over and over and over again, regardless of those individuals that come and go within our engineering departments. So, and then lastly, it allows engineers and designers to focus on more important processes. And I've been saying this for a long time now. I mean, designers and engineers, they get paid very good money to do what they do. But if all they're doing is filling out documentation or inputting information manually over and over again, these redundant and repetitive tasks take away from what they truly are passionate about. You know, they want to solve problems and they want to do things, not those types of mundane tasks. If those things exist within your processes, perhaps iLogic is a means to alleviate those steps and allow our designers and engineers to do things a bit more valuable for the company.